Start out, take your backing. We're using scrap, so I have a scrap backing. It's 5 by 5. Lay it down, and then take your matting, cut it smaller, about 1/2 inch smaller than your backing, and lay it on top. Once you do that, you're going to take your first piece. It's going to go in the middle and lay it a little bit above the corner, like so. These are scraps, so don't mind going over. Then take your second piece and lay it face down, just like that. Take a couple of pins, real quick. If you have a pin, you're going to sew along this edge right there. Remove the pins, cut off a little bit of the excess. Once you do that, open it up, like so. Take your iron, iron it flat. Take another piece, place it face down, and you're going to sew right here. Normally, you may want to pin it together. However, this is just a little area. I can do that without pinning. Like before, cut off some of the excess. Fold it over. Do the same thing to the other side. Just like before, you're going to want to cut off the excess. Fold it over. And iron. Once you have this, you need to cut off the extra. This is very important. You need to fold this back and pin it down. Now that you have all these sides pinned, we need to cut. Take a straight edge. And the reason why I say take a straight edge is you don't want to cut here or you'll ruin it. So take a straight edge, go just a tad past that. Typically, when pull-as-you-go squares are made, they're made like this. Everything is sewn right to the edge and then cut off. It's not the way I make them because it makes it terribly difficult to sew them together. So I do it a different way. Usually, a piece like this is made, just a strip folded in, and it goes down on both sides, one on the front and one on the back. However, that means on one side you're sewing blind. I hate to sew blind. This is my solution. I take two squares and I lay them on top of each other, back to back. I pin them together and then I sew down this line here. As usual, once you have it sewn, you unfold it and iron it flat. There's a lot of ironing flat in this. That's the back. This is the front. Open this area up and iron it flat. Once you have that trimmed and laying flat, take your cover piece, like so, and pin it on to make sure it stays, and then you're going to sew down the sides. And there you go. Here's the front, here's the back. Back's not as impressive, but you can see it went right down. Here's the front, all stitched up.